Alrighty, welcome to round one of an extended daily event here with Nother Than Fairies for a big surprise. I'm gonna go ahead and play first. And yeah, that's a pretty easy keep. I mean, Bitter Blossom might not be as good as it was before Besieged, but it's still pretty sweet. Alright. Leading with a tapped Secluded Glen. See what we're battling against. Some sort of Bant deck, it looks like. Alright, let's see how Blossom does. I have to admit, game one against Bant might be kind of tough if he, depending on what he plays right here, like a Mirran Crusader. Knight of the Reliquary, alright. He cannot activate it currently, though. That's pretty good. Alright. This isn't actually looking too bad. I mean, if he doesn't, he probably has a basic for Knight, otherwise, he wouldn't have slammed it. Though, maybe not. And I can pretty much counter anything he plays, though I'm not going to counter Noble Hierarch. I'm going to go ahead and take four here. I can take a hit without a whole lot of problems. So, it'd be nice to draw more colored sources. There you go. And we'll go ahead and. Let's see, I can beat down. I think I'll pass in the beatdowns because. Now, if he doesn't have a fetch land or something like that, well, if he attacked with the knight, I could block with Mutavault plus two fairy tokens. Noble Hierarch. Question is, do I want to trade a Mutavault for it? And I do not think I do. I think I'll just take another hit. I don't mind being a little aggressive with my life total just because there's not they don't have a whole lot of reach, so. Alright, let's reveal another Bitter Blossom, though we definitely do not want to play a second Bitter Blossom. Now it's time to just go on the beatdowns, especially since he's with two Exalted guys, he's probably just attacking with one guy, so I can just start chumping. He's probably not going to get anything too fancy, just some fetch lands, but I can just keep blocking the knight, so it's not that big of a concern. He can't really play much either here, since I've got a bunch of counter spells. Alright, it's gonna go ahead and Tech Edge a Secluded Glen to cut me off of Cryptic Command, but that's okay. I've got both Spellstarter and Mana Leak up, which should do the trick fairly well. These actually work pretty well together, as people have no doubt observed in the past, where Mana Leak plus Spellstarter combine, so they can't play anything cheap or expensive. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and chump this knight here. And even if he's not playing anything, this isn't going too poorly. I mean, he's not advancing his board. Like, he's using a knight or whatever, but I'm still attacking him for two. I'm losing a life a turn. And I've got a bunch of counters, so if he plays anything, I actually just get to counter it. Let's see what he comes up with. He probably wants to play around Mana Leak if he can. Alright, yeah. Continue chumping. I can spell stutter anything up to a 5. No, 6 even. Yeah, so that's definitely getting spell stuttered. Yeah. Though now we're a little out of counters. If we don't draw a blue source, then we can't really counter a whole lot. Since Mana Leak is. That's not quite what I wanted. Mana Leak is not going to be good enough here. But that's okay. We can still apply the beatdowns. Don't want to attack with the other Mutavault because I need to keep Mana Leak up because I definitely have to play Dark Slick Shores in order to keep Cryptic up next turn. Mirran Crusader. Yep. It's not that big of a deal. I mean, I'm not like thrilled about it, but. Between Cryptic Command, my Mutavaults, and just chumping with guys, it looks like I'm in pretty good shape here. I don't know if the Bant I don't think the Bant decks usually play much in the way of counter magic. At least I hope not. I don't think I want to cast that because I would like to. I think I'd like to Cryptic Command all those guys because that will presumably kill them. Let's see, seven, yeah, and then. can't really attack with Mutavolts because he's got a Mirran Crusader. So I think on his upkeep is when I want a Cryptic, because that reduces the chances that he draws something sweet. And then even if he has a counter, it's not like I'm dead. I still have a Fairy Token and a Mutavolt to chump his two big guys. So I think I like the way this is looking. And Mana Leak doesn't stop me. Only Cryptic Command stops me. I'm not sure what instance he could have here. Possibly a Vendilion Click? Like I said, the Bant lists can play a lot of different cards. Like, they're not necessarily pigeonholed into one particular list. Unsurprisingly, it does not look like he's going to block. Oh, and he lost connection. Alright, so he goes to 7 here. On his upkeep, I'm going to Cryptic, tapping all his creatures and drawing a card. Definitely don't want to be like bounce any permanents, because then he could fizzle them with Knight. Tapping Edge so I can leave double Mutavolt activation up if he like tries to kill the first one. Aha, Bant Charm. Okay. I can't do anything about that, so it's fine. Like I said, still not dead here because of Mutavolts. I doubt he's got multiple Tectonic Edges either, but who knows. So I'm at 7. I could take 4 off the Mirran Crusader, go to 4, and then chump the Knight. Definitely want to activate Mutavolt, leaving Mutavolt up in case he kills the first Mutavolt. I don't think this game is going to last long enough that I need to chump both guys. I think going to 4 off Mirran Crusader is fine, because I'm planning on killing him in 2 swings with my dudes. Let's see what he's got going on in there. Nothing. Alright. So unless he's got a second Tectonic Edge, I should be in good shape. I attack for 4 and then kill him next turn after chumping twice. He can't attack me with Celestial Colonnade because of Tectonic Edges. I've got a Mana Leak 2, but that's not really going to do a whole lot here. Let's see what he ends up doing. He drew something. I know, he's activating Celestial Colonnade, I think, is what it is. Yeah, that's more than fine. Alright. Activate El Mutavolto. Block. Block. Tech Edge the Colonnade. And Profit. Alright. On to game 2. So, let's take a look at the build real quick. I actually have 3 Mistbind Clicks, but that's just because I wanted to fit a fourth sower in, and I thought the 4 curve was just going to be too high. Even if I put all the sowers on the board, I'd be taking out Mistbind Clicks. So at that point, I'm just going to play 3. So against that Bant deck full of Mirran Crusaders, this is where you want the Sower of Temptations. Do not really want Vendilions. I like Disfigures and Doomblades, even though he's got Mirran Crusader and Sword of Feast and Famine, which just make this removal a little worse. Disfigure and Doomblade still works out pretty well. On the draw, I don't really like Mana Leak, and I usually cut one of the hand disruption spells. Nighthawk, I don't think is effective enough. It doesn't do anything against Sword or Mirran Crusader. It doesn't really race Knight, so if they have a Knight, you're just kind of holding your Nighthawk back. And instead, the plan is to use a bunch of 4-drops, though you end up a little heavy on the 4s. It's possible that instead of one of the Mistbind Clicks... Yeah, I guess I could go... Instead of one of the Mistbind Clicks, go back to one of the Mana Leaks. All right. Yeah, that seems reasonable.